It took me that long because I've been a part of a family on the GB team for the past 5 years, and I've just been like, I go there Monday to Thursday every week, and it's like my home. So to turn professional, I'm on my own now, and I think it's just my personal ambition to be successful and to turn pro and see how far I can go. I think if I would have stayed amateur for another 4 years and even went the next Olympics, I always wanted to turn professional and see how far I could have went. So it's just on a personal note that I wanted to turn pro, and I think I've got a great promoter in Eddie, I've got a great manager in Neil, I've got great training. So it's just about getting my head down now and picking the right fights at the right time, and then hopefully get me to the top. Never know what's around the corner, and before the Olympics, like, I was like the most, like, I medalled in everything we've been at, like the Commonwealths, the Worlds and the Europeans, and like, I never thought I wasn't going to medal at the Olympics. And when it didn't happen, and it was the biggest tournament in the world where you get the most recognition from, I just thought, oh, and I thought to myself, over the next 4 years, I didn't think I'd have it in my heart to go to the World Championships, the Europeans, and all them tournaments. So that's why I thought, you know what, I'm going to turn professional and give it a go. Of course, the ambition is to be a world champion. That's why I want to turn professional, because it's every kid's ambition to be a world champion, and I believe I've got the skill to do that, but it's just, you just need a little bit of luck, you need the right people behind you, and I feel with Eddie and Matchroom, I've got all the boxes are ticked.